You know, I didn't have to pay bills and stuff like that before. You know, I'm 21 now. I'm in the league. Now it's like, oh, you got to find a home. You know, you got to find your vehicle to drive in, you know, from work to home each and every day. You got to find a place for your family to call home. And that's pretty cool.
Lamar Jackson might have captured the attention of the entire sporting world, but this Baltimore Ravens quarterback seems totally intent on keeping the public at a distance from his private life. Ever since his high school football days, this young man and his family have kept a relatively low profile, oftentimes declining interview attempts for both local and national media outlets. This 23-year-old former Heisman Trophy winner and current reigning undisputed MVP of the league rarely shares information about his private life, and that includes the details on his home located in Owing Mills, Baltimore County. As of right now, Lamar is currently in the middle of his $9.5 million four-year rookie deal with Baltimore. He received nearly $5 million in a signing bonus upon putting his name to ink, and then received roughly a further $2.38 million in annual salary for each year after. With that being the case, most estimates of his current net worth peg him to be sitting in the $4 to $5 million range. What makes these figures so special isn't the money he's getting paid, but the production he's generating on the field while getting paid so considerably little. Last season, Lamar threw a league-leading 36 touchdowns against only 6 interceptions, and he's amassed 4,333 total yards rushing.
It's a second down and 3. Jackson takes it himself. Look at him dart back and forth. Oh! He broke his ankles! Now he's got an entourage! And he's got a touchdown!
But in the face of a worldwide pandemic, even talent like that finds itself doing much the same thing we're all doing right now, hunkering down at home and waiting everything out. While self-quarantining, Lamar has been passing the time by playing video games, working out, and posting funny video clips to his social media accounts, particularly ones that feature his good friend, Big Choppa. Hey guys and girls, it's Kara here for you with another house tour, this one taking a look at Baltimore Ravens quarterback and reigning NFL MVP, Lamar Jackson. Now, like I mentioned off the top, Lamar keeps the details about his private life, well, private. So while I do have some insider details to share with you about his home in Owings Mills, including a few pictures, I'm also gonna spend some time today taking a look at what his quarantine life has been like to help provide a fuller picture for all of you. If you like these videos, make sure you're subscribed and ring that bell to be notified when we post so you can always be up to date. We've also done house tours on the likes of Kelly Rowland and Robert De Niro, and we'll link to some at the end. Follow me on Instagram to chat, and as usual, let me know whose house tour is next in those comments down below. Now let's get into this video. Now we might as well kick this video off with what you guys have come to see, so let's take a look at Lamar Jackson's home in Owings Mills, Baltimore County, or at the very least, pictures of a home that's probably a lot like Jackson's. Those pictures you're seeing on screen are actually images taken from the inside of the former Baltimore Stars home, Ray Lewis. Lewis lived in the exact same neighborhood as Jackson, and his home sold for $1.1 million back in 2013. When Jackson purchased his home in the same neighborhood about 4 or 5 years later, he paid $900,000, so this home should be comparable in design and size, but of course, they've probably decorated it totally different. Property records show that Jackson's home was built in the 90s and belongs to a Florida-based LLC owned by Felicia Jones, Lamar's mother, and current business manager.
I can go back to high school, you know, I sat out my 10th grade season due to my grades, lack on my behalf, and she would tell me, you know, you're gonna train like you plan. And I used to hate it. Like, I used to catch attitude, like, I don't wanna train today, you know, but she still take me anyway. And when I get there, you know, it all get in my head, like, man, you here for a reason, just get better. So anytime I wouldn't say I doubted myself, but when I wanna get lazy and don't wanna do stuff, she tell me, like, you gotta come, like, come on with it, cause it was your fault, you know, you wasn't able to play on this field this season, so you gonna keep training each and every day until you back out there next year. So I owe it all to her.
After signing his rookie contract in 2018, the very first purchase that Jackson made was to buy this home for both himself and his entire family, including his mother and 3 younger brothers.
Well, from the time we was younger, I always knew he was special. I just didn't know how important it was from when we were outside playing to you jumping over my head in the backyard. I knew it was something special about you.
Jackson has said in the past that he chose his mother to be his manager because no one knows him better than she does. He said, "I didn't want to put my life in someone else's hands. I would rather put them into hers." And that's exactly what he did. By moving in with her, she's remained a part of his life 24/7. Now their home is only about 20 minutes away from the Ravens practice facility, and many different Ravens players live in this neighborhood. In fact, the entire area of Baltimore County is flooded with the city's NFL players living in Owen Mills and neighboring areas due to the close proximity to where they train. Moving on to the details of this place, the exterior of the home reportedly features a pool as well as a 3-car garage. Meanwhile, on the inside of this 5,000 square foot home are wooden floors, a first floor master bedroom suite with an attached sitting room, multiple walk-in closets, and a massive kitchen featuring state-of-the-art appliances and a large kitchen island. If these pictures are anything to go by, then Lamar will also have an epic-sized living room to collect all of his memorabilia and trophies in. But let's be honest, Lamar might need himself an even bigger trophy room for all of the hardware he's gonna collect over the years. He might even need a bigger house. In terms of his bathrooms, I'm sure they're built with the idea of sparing no expense and feature the nicest of accommodations, including a sauna. But Lamar, I hope you didn't use the same color palette as Rated for this bathroom. That's a little too close to The Shining for me. All right, now that we've taken a look at this home a little bit, let's see how Lamar has been handling his self-quarantine. He told CNBC, "Quarantine keeps me off the field, so I'll be back in the backyard just throwing the ball." Despite still being able to get his necessary practice in, Lamar admits that throwing the ball long distance has been difficult to accomplish given the circumstances and the size of his backyard. Of course, he hasn't been restricting his training only to the physical space. He's also hopped onto Zoom calls from inside of his home to keep up with his workouts by talking to his coaches and trainers. But what helps this 6'2", 212-pound man really relax might surprise you a little bit. He credits his yoga and Pilates training with keeping him mentally tough through these trying times. He told CNBC, "Before I was doing it twice a week. I was doing yoga twice a week and Pilates twice a week. It makes life go better. It makes your days better. The workouts relax your muscles and your mind. It lets your mind breathe." Nowadays, Jackson's practicing these workouts in the comfort of his own home with the help of an app. And because technology is so clearly the future, Jackson has recently teamed up with a company called Status Pro to develop a first-person virtual reality game called, and I promise you I'm not making this up, the Lamar Jackson Experience. This new game, which is expected to debut sometime this fall, will give its players the opportunity to play pro football through Jackson's eyes. Lamar has even already tested the game out himself and given it his stamp of approval, saying, "I have fun playing it. It's a workout, you sweat." He might be a man of few words, but that's just because his actions speak so loudly. According to reports, during the course of the game, players will move, throw, and rush yards just like Jackson would do on the gridiron, all without having to leave the comfort of their own home. Now, as this new football season finally kicks off this week, Lamar will finally find himself out of his home and back onto the field. And I think I speak for a lot of us when I say it's about damn time. Alright guys, I think we're gonna end this house tour here. What did you think of Lamar's home, and what are the odds that the inside of his place is better decorated than Ray Lewis's crib was? Let me know your thoughts down below. Don't forget to follow me on Instagram, and I'll see you guys all in the next one. Bye!